Joe Black. Run me the keys, run me the bees, run me that float back. You're top three, I'm not number one, how could you post that? I want a crowd, the city is mine, you cannot hold that. I'm not the one to go back. Meet Joe Black, meet Joe Black. Why would I ever have to cop a chain again when it can be chain birth most of the chains in the game?
The NFL is on EA Sports, and we're at Raymond James Stadium in Tampa, Florida. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the Dallas Cowboys and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Here's the punter, Jake Kamara, set to do the honors, and off we go now from Tampa. Fields it right around the goal line. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further. We step aside here in this first quarter. On second and 12, Prescott. And that nearly an interception here on this opening drive, but he gets a reprieve. It's third down.
Oh, man, that was close. That opportunity to change momentum. Big play right in his hands. Unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on the defensive. That fell harmlessly to the ground. Three and out. A real danger here on their opening drive as they come up on a third and 12. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
That was their first third down try of the game, and clearly something was off in the execution of that play. Good news, they've got a whole game left to clean that up and start clicking on those key third down throws.
Got to throw on fourth. He'll find Lamb. That's complete. And unable to break away. They stop him a few yards shy. A surprising move here on the opening drive of the game. And on the opening drive of the afternoon, the defense forces a turnover on downs. Down carry, and he's going to get this one down inside the 15. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3. Pretty effective run there, and now they can start to smell that end zone.
Pound the rock. Make sure you use your O-line to set the tone of dominance and physicality, and pound the rock.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. They'll run it again with Fournette. And tackled down after a gain of 3. Leaves him with 1 yard to go on 3rd down.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles. Because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, That's a big day.
They'll run it here with Bernard. And this is not going to be enough. Was in search of 2 yards and only got halfway there. And Brady will sneak it. And he'll be touched out here, but not before he does pick up the first. They only needed a few inches, and they didn't get much more than that. But by about the width of a shoelace, they convert on fourth down. Now he'll throw with Brady. And he's just going to throw this one out of bounds here. Nowhere to go with it. Incomplete.
This is where good coaching and execution come into play, because down this close, you absolutely don't want to turn it over. Good job keeping that in mind as he escaped, bought time, and decided throwing it away was his best option.
On second down, here's Fournette. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Officially nothing on that one, no gain, so they're left with still 10 to go on third down. And as a defensive end, getting off the ball quickly, swarming to the football, making a tackle, that's what we saw right there.
Yeah, that's what their job is, and really a lot of the time they have to throttle back a little bit in the run game, because you know those defensive ends, they're like in a sprinter stance, they're just headed straight for the quarterback. That was good recognition on that play to hold them to no gain.
Throwing is Brady on third down. And it's caught. And he takes this down to about the 2 before going out of bounds. A gain of 8 there on the play. And that'll bring up fourth down.
So Brady departs, and on is Ryan Suckup for the Buccaneer field goal.
From the left hash, he'll have to cut this at a tight angle. Suckup's kick is good. And the Bucs take a 3-0 lead. Take the early lead.
There's no doubt about it. They will always take the early lead, and maybe that celebration comes later if they play well and they can break things open. But right now, this is all about letting the offense just get settled in.
And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They'll start the drive with Elliott. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4. Prescott off play action. Gonna take a shot for Gallup. And that's gonna be incomplete. Great. Trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
Certainly came out firing in this one. They ruled that one was incomplete. I can't imagine that would be the last shot they take in this game.
Now they face a 3rd down and 4 after that incompletion on 2nd down. To throw is Prescott. And that is incomplete.
Nice back-to-back plays defensively. They're stacking momentum now. 1 incompletion, 2 incompletion, they're going for more.
On 4th down, here's Brian Anger now to kick this one away. He steps into this one, and this is a rocket. And that one hits a little too close to the goal line, and it continues into the end zone for a touchback. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. They've got a 3-0 lead and the football as they start 1st and 10.
Hey, Alabama, Alabama. 72. 150. Alpha.
Here's Brady. Dumps it off to Fournette. And he
stopped right at the 25 after a gain of 5.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
From the 25 on second down, Brady, and he will go down, a Cowboys sack. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game. Well, he shot in, CD, like he was out of a cannon from that linebacker position, and even though they had a running back in the backfield, no one could stop him.
Well, you certainly diagnosed that play perfectly because as fast as he got into the backfield, you're exactly right. The running back had no shot to get over and try to protect his quarterback, and a sack resulted.
From the gun on third down, Brady. It's caught by Mike Evans. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. That's a third down conversion of 24 yards there. Nice play.
I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere. And they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well. And that's what they just did on that play.
3-0 after one on EA Sports. And they'll send the tight end in motion left. On first and 10, here's Brady. And that's complete. It's Chris Godwin. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another first down. Up the gut, Fournette. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. In motion, the tight end.
Hey, ball 66.
On second and 12, Brady escaping the pressure right. And he'll just get rid of it.
Well, sometimes the defense just beats you. Great coverage from the secondary. All of them in the proper position. So instead of trying to throw into tight coverage, he found a way to throw it away and come back and try again the next down.
This offense on third down today, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is third down and 12.
Go Bandit! Hey, 66.
To throw is Brady. Powers through him. The pass is caught by Cade Otton. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 28. His first catch, and it's a pretty big one. They get the conversion on third down.
And that's well executed there on third down. And I love the confidence that they had to let their tight end try and find some space in the middle of the field right in their quarterback's line of vision. And QBs love to make that easy throw, and they hooked up there for a first down.
They had to settle for 3 last drive, hoping this second go-around ends in 6. In good position, first and 10. They go back to the ground now with Fournette. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10.
Ozzie! Ozzie!
Brady. That one thrown away from the pocket. The officials kind of looking at each other, but they'll say there was a receiver in the area, so no penalty, just an incomplete pass.
Sympathies lie with the defense. You understand how tough it is for linebackers to run with a guy like this. He's going to slip out of the backfield and then work in the middle of the field. And sometimes those defenders get preoccupied with other people.
And he's in. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Leonard Fournette, a 5-yard touchdown run as his guys are able to extend their lead. Extra point put through by Suckup, and the lead grows to 10-0. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a first down now. And they'll get to him quickly here as he'll get a yard, just a yard to the 22.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up a score.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. They go to Elliott again. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd and 9 situation. Come to the line here needing 9 yards to pick up the first. On 3rd down, it's Prescott. And that will be incomplete.
He's smart enough to avoid the taunting rule, but I'll guarantee he quietly has told them, you might want to stop coming after me downfield because I just broke up another pass and took away a big shot that you were trying to succeed with.
The Bucs going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. And it's going to be batted down. It will go the other way with the football. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And the Bucs are going to take over with excellent field position to boot. Thank you. inside handoff now to Fournette. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts. And they'll be disappointed to have to burn one there after giving up the first down.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
They keep it with Fournette on first down. And that play going absolutely nowhere as he's belted before he could get out of the backfield. Call it a full 3 yards in the wrong direction there. Brings up second down.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
So their task a little bit more difficult now. Second and 13 that they're walking up on. Again, it's Fournette. And nowhere to run on the interior of that defensive line. He'll get back only to the line of scrimmage.
Early down stuff will put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
Send this one away. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And with a little under a minute remaining, they may try to put something together here just to try to cut into that deficit. Meanwhile, Dak's throw there caught by Gallup. The Cowboys signal for their third and final timeout as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. First and 10 here. You know, if they could just get three out of this, there's something about narrowing it to a two-score game at half that makes it feel like much less of an obstacle. Forced out to his left. Throw left side complete. That's Elliott. And he goes out of bounds. It looks like right at the 50. Short completion, just 4 yards, and that'll make it second down. Prescott now from the 50. Complete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on. Third down.
Might help me out here a little bit, partner, because what I'm seeing is a passing game that's just struggling to complete anything. No rhythm, no timing. Seems like every pass is also contested well. So give some credit to the defense.
Throwing there, but this pass is going to wind up incomplete.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. It came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
The Bucs forced to use their third and final timeout as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime. Now Prescott on fourth down. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert. And they turn it over. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And this defense will take over right at midfield. The Buccaneers in good field position here to start out first and 10 right at the 50-yard line. From midfield, here's Brady. He completes it to Evans. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 14 yards there and a Buccaneer first down. So Brady departs, and on it's Ryan Succop for the Buccaneer field goal. Succop's kick is good, and that will extend their lead even further. So not the greatest of first halves for him, but a little ray of light here at the end. The late turnover becomes 3 points before the break.
But it certainly needed something positive to go their way. Maybe 3 points doesn't seem like a huge deal in the grand scheme of things, but at least it's something to build on as they head into the half.
A fairly short kick from the 14. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it out past the 30. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And with 7 seconds remaining, not much time to really do anything. Oh, the Buccaneer pressure too much. Down he goes. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. The Bucs with a lead, and they'll get the football first as the second half is underway. So they accept the penalty, of course, and push the offense backwards a bit. So, first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material. Fournette on the counter. And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
The last run got 6, now second and 4. Met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. Now Brady. He'll check this one off to Fournette. And they're going to get this down near the 35-yard line.
They certainly had success throughout this contest getting him the ball in the passing game, and there he picks up another first down. Whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it, and no adjustment has been made to take it away.
It's a room to maneuver, and he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. 48 yards rushing on 12 carries for him now. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Take it a yard or so past the 20, caught at the 21. shot set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense.
Well, we haven't exactly been treated to a nail biter in this one, CD, and if they cannot score here, this one's pretty much all but over.
All right, Sam, did you feel like people are starting to think about getting out of here and maybe beating the traffic in order to get home or to their final destination?
Yeah, I don't think there's a whole lot of reason to hang around, especially if they can't score here.
Yeah, you're right about that, because it has been pretty clear who the better team has been in this one. And in a league that we talk about every game being a one-score game as we go into it, watching this blowout, let's just say it's been unusual.
We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
That means they have to win the 50-50. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with them.
And this time, contact and another incomplete pass. They tried the throw on second down, unsuccessful. Now it's third and one. Trying to run for it with Pollard. And he's able to get it to the 33. Good enough for a first down. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Looking to throw. Prescott. He'll fire this deep for Gallup. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone.
It's been clear in this matchup which side has been the more physical one. It's been this defense. And here's another example on that last play.
Off the play fake, Prescott. And down he goes, a Buccaneer sack. They'll need a big play here on the back of the Cowboys after the sack. It's third and long. Knocked away in the middle of the field and incomplete.
As a coaching staff, you can call just about whatever you want, because you understand you have guys who reliably take away those massive shots downfield. You're not as worried about giving up the big one.
The Cowboys will go. Prescott. He'll fire deep downfield for Lamb. And that's caught inside the 30. Wow, first and goal, and defensively all they can do is shake their heads. Not only did they allow the conversion, but a big play as well. On play action, Prescott. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. Dak Prescott. A four-yard touchdown scamper. And the Cowboys are able to make some inroads here to that deficit. So that, Charles, their first score of the ball game, obviously, coming here in the third quarter. Is that going to be enough to energize the troops?
It's a great question, and we'll wait to see the answer, but it's finally something for them to build on. Now they know that they can actually score against that defense.
So they go with a pass there on the two-point try and able to convert it, Charles.
And a good job by the offense figuring out their two-point play and using it well. It's interesting how people are using the strategy nowadays, though, isn't it?
It really is, and I don't know how much that one, that particular play, factored in, but with the PAT moving back in 15-16, that kind of changed things, didn't it?
It's really a part of everyone's strategy now. When I talk with coaches and when we sit with them, they always talk about they actually have two-point periods in practice now, something they never really did before.
Here's a give to Fournette. Call that a gain of five as the clock ticks inside of 2 minutes to go now in the third. The first down run got five. Here's second and five. A handoff to Fournette. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. Forward on the straight ahead running for just a couple of yards, second down.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground, but I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
On play action, it's Brady. This is caught by And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Mike Evans, 32 yards.
And the Bucs will add on to their lead here in the final minute of the third.
Extra point up and good by Succa. And that will bump the lead up to 26. The Bucs ready for the kickoff. And here we go. It's in the air. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. A strong showing their last time out. They scored the touchdown, but Charles, they looked up and they're still down double digits, so you feel like just to keep pace, this drive probably needs to end in the end zone as well.
Yeah, I think the best move for them is to not worry about how far they are down on the scoreboard, but to just remember the last drive and how it ended. Go ahead and try and repeat that. Then you can look at the scoreboard and see where this game is.
On second and 12, Prescott. It's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
At this point in the game and the situation in the environment, these incompletions that we're seeing, they need to turn into positive snaps and soon.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Here's Prescott. And that's Elliott, complete. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play. Desperation time. Prescott on fours. That'll be taken in there by James Washington. And he is going to have the Cowboys first down as that'll be a gain of 15 on fourth. Play fake. Here's Prescott. Oh, the Buccaneer pressure too much. Down he goes. More than one defender there, and that's a loss of five on the sack.
But one thing I do know, these guys on defense, they don't want this game to end. They're winning by multiple touchdowns. They've shut down the opposing quarterback in a big way, and they're still picking up sacks as we approach the end of this one.
To try again after the sack, Prescott sliding out of the pocket. And this will be well too low for him to bring in. It's incomplete.
I think you can easily follow the thinking there. The pressure on the last play, it got to him. So they decided, let's get him out of there. Bootleg him out to the right. Unable to complete the pass downfield. But the thought process, spot on.
This offense so far on third down, it's been a problem. Just 1 for 7 thus far. This will be third and 15.
Open man, Lamb. It's complete.
And this is going to lead to another first down as the tackle's made at the Bucs' 32-yard line. To throw is Prescott. And it's intercepted at the goal line.